Hi everyone, I hope you all safe and sound, and I would like to invite you to our Genesis YouTube Hub. This hub is prepared mostly for all of you who would like to learn something new. We came to this hub with the idea of doing something for the beginners, but not only. So we'll try to fill up our tutorials with a lot of techniques, with a lot of good advices, and I hope you stay with us. Right now you can see all the sponsors which are taking part in this hub, and this is us, the whole group of artists who are taking part in this hub. I prepare for you art journal page, and so I'm gonna speak like I would speak to a totally beginner. I was showing you two different types of journaling I'm doing. I'm either using old books or I'm using a notebook. This is not a special notebook. This is not a mixed media art journal. This is just a notebook which has quite a thick pages. And if you have a notebook like that, you are just good to go. So I will talk about the hub a little bit later, but for now let me talk to you a little bit about the technique, about the process I'm doing. So if you have a notebook like that, very good thing is to actually prime the page. So you prime the page firstly with gesso. You can use either clear gesso or a white gesso. Some people could even use a layer of white acrylic, but the gesso is the best. But if you don't have it, try with acrylic. And so you dry it on. And well, I started with stamping. I really love the stamping. I didn't want the page to be complicated. So I started with stamping, and right now I'm showing you how to do masking, because that's something when you stamp you quite often may need. Because I'm using geometrical motifs, which are quite easy to stamp and to cut out, that's what I'm gonna be doing. I'm gonna be doing masking. I'm using post-it notes to do the masking, because they have this adhesive part which I can later use to glue to the paper, even though in this case, right now you see me, I'm actually not using the adhesive part, because, well, that's me. I sometimes do silly mistakes like that. But I cut two other parts in green. They are all coming from this stamp from Longrec Limage, and I cut them out. And I'm gonna show you in a moment how to do masking. Right now, because the stamp is quite new, it's not having a very good impressions. So I am stamping it on the piece of paper to make it work better, to have a better and crisper image. And if you don't want the stamping images to go on top of each other without any order, that's why you use the masking. And right now I'm working on the composition on the page. I will be working with this one stamp in particular, or maybe only with this one, I don't even remember right now. But I will, I'm trying that the pieces don't go, the single stamps don't go on top of each other. So I am working first with the paper cuts I made from this stamp, and I'm making my composition. And as you can see here, because I am recording with my phone, I cannot take a picture of the composition, which I like. I draw it very quickly, so like that I have an idea later. I can have I have a cheat sheet basically, to have a look at it and make the same composition. And as you know, the creative process is not always that easy. So at the end, I kind of changed the layout on the page. And look, guys, at that. That's how you do masking. I know a lot of you knows well how to do masking, probably better than me. But for those of you who don't know, this is the way to do it. Well, first I stamp my image. That would be the kind of the focal image on this page, because it's the biggest one. And as you can see, I cannot use my Misty machine because I'm working in an art journal. So it's just too bulky to put it inside the machine. So I was pressing a lot of strength, or putting a lot of strength into stamping the image, and it did not work perfectly. The images, when you stamp them, the way they stamp, it depends also on the paper you use. You've seen me stamping on the piece of paper before, and it stamped really well. On this paper, which is a little bit more grainy, the image is not as perfect. So I fix it a little bit with Uniball or Unipen This is permanent marker, so you have to be careful to use permanent marker and permanent ink. I'm using Stazon if you want to add colors later. And now I'm doing my masking. So I put the cutted image of the stamp on top of the stamp. And now I'm taking another stamp from the same set and I'm stamping it over the masking paper. And so like that, they are kind of connected, but one is behind the other and it looks very, to me, coherent and nice. So you don't have to, you know, stamp them separately. You can actually stamp them all together. And with the masking paper or with the masking technique, you can achieve this effect that the images will not overlap each other. I hope I make sense in my explanation. If not, if you want to ask me a question, please leave me a comment and I will gladly answer. I will come back a little to the hop. So we are running this hop, Genesis hop, for 14 days. So it will run until 5th of May. And you have a quiet time to watch all of our videos because that's the whole idea of the hop. We want to teach you something, but we also want your support. And we offer you at the end possibility to win some nice prizes. But to participate in the hop, or participate in the draw actually, you have to watch our videos, subscribe to our channels if you haven't done so, and comment with your name and with the name of the country you are coming from, because some of the prizes are actually not sent worldwide. And of course, leave us some good feedback, please, and some questions if you have so. As you can see, I keep on stamping and I keep on fixing the not the perfect impression. I wish these stamping images would be more crisp and more dark. But as I said, you can always fix a little bit by using the pen like I'm using. So this one is the permanent ink, so you can still add some color, add some water on top of that. That will be my next step. I will be adding color and I will be adding, well, first water, then the color. I'm using Lindy's Gang sprays. They are two different ones. Moonshadow Mist and Starburst, Delphinium Turquoise, Buccaneer Bay Blue. And with these sprays, you have to be very careful to shake them well, so the powder, which stays normally on the bottom, is actually moved, it moves around. And you can, like that, get the best of the color. So, as you can see, I'm dipping my brush into water. And for this project, I want to stay in lines. I want to stay exactly where the stamps are. I will try not to go over the stamped image. Even though I am also not very, very careful. And I don't do exactly I don't put exactly the color where the image is, sorry. And that's because I like a little bit of distress look. And this is my art journaling. I don't fill up exactly the color in the lines because I found it's nicer that way. It has more interest. So the first one I use is the Moonshadow. Moonshadow has a little bit of brown color in it. And this one in particular is blue and brown. And it shines, it's really, really nice. And of course, I dried the color. And when you dry and when you use the heat gun, you're supposed to dry from both sides. So like that, you will avoid the warping of the page. And now I will not add water, but I will just dip my brush in water a little bit and then in the bottle of the blue spray. And I will add a little bit of blue onto the page. I try to also cover these small lines here, as you can see. And then I let it dry with... well, I didn't let it dry, I actually heat dried. Guys, can you see the shine? I really, really love it. And there is another secret to Lindy's sprays. I actually use Lindy's so I can talk about them. I don't know about other sprays. When you add color on top of the color, they will actually react with each other. They will make a sort of dance and they will give you a lot of spots, a lot of stains, and this is really, really beautiful. And here I decided to use a little bit of brighter blue, that's Tiffany Lou Blue. And again, I'm adding it to the page like before. Just dipping the brush firstly a little bit in water, then in the bottle, and just drying it with the, or heat setting it with the heat gun. I use also these two triangles. They are coming from Longre L'Image, La Vie d'Artiste. And they are just paper triangles, kind of stickers. Well, they are not stickers because I have to stick them with tacky glue. And this one I cut so it matches perfectly the top figure. And the other I cut a little bit on the bottom so it's smaller, because they were both the same size. And like that I have this kind of, how would you call it, asymmetry. And this is also very nice, especially in geometrical projects. I didn't want to add any color to the triangles I'm gluing right now, so I decided to add a tiny, about tiny, or quite small dots. They are the stickers I made, and I found that the color is matching very well the color of the project, so I add just two stickers, so like that it's more, to me, coherent. And I will also add some ribbons from Timbalt. This is one of my favorite mixed media products. I'm not sure if they are not discontinued because I cannot find them anywhere. They are called Remnant Wraps, and basically they are numbers. And I really love them, even though they are quite hard to actually stick to the page. So you have to work quite hard to manage, or you have to be lucky, because sometimes they just stick to the page perfectly, others other times you have to just really work on it. And there it is, wait for it, my big mishap in this art journaling. I was working so hard to try to find a good way this number 8 goes, and I actually put it upside down, which is not a big deal, because doing the numbers upside down is quite well known in the art journaling in craft, so it's not not a problem, but really it's just sometimes, you know, you just completely lose your mind when you are journaling. You are somewhere in the zone and you just don't think. And now I'm gonna, of course, add some splatter. And for that I'm using acrylic black paint. And I'm trying first on the page beside, because I want to know how big the splatter will be. So, you know, depending on the brush you use and on the density, of course, of the paint. So this is gonna be my focal point. It's a photo I took from internet. This is a copyright free photo, and I find them on the pixabay.com. So if you wanna look for the photos for you, you can just do it there, or look there. And this is the idea which my friend Nuneka gave me, because I used to cut the, you know, rectangular or square photos, but she actually reminded me of something. The photos can be also fuzzy cut, and so that's what I've done. I really love this girl with a big but this is lion actually. I decided to give her wings because I love the wings, so I took the acetate wings from Tim Holtz and I cut them in the middle, and I glued them but also asymmetrically, so it looks like, you know, they are folded. And I glue them also with tacky glue, a tiny bit of tacky glue in the middle of her back. Now I'll add some 3D foam tape to the back, and I put the picture on the piece of clean tissue, so not to leave the sticky the traces of your sticky fingers on the photo paper. And she is gonna go just here. Firstly, I was thinking she's gonna go a little bit around the number 8, my unfortunate number 8, and I will cover it like that a little bit. But then I decided, actually with the help of my husband, he told me that she looks just the best here. And so let's let him a little bit of impact in my art journaling. And this is the sentiment I printed out also. I sometimes print out my sentiments just on the normal photo paper, and then I glue them on the cardstock like that. I cut them out and ink the edges with archival ink or Stazon, and like that they are not very flat, they don't bend with the glue. And for the finishing touches, a little bit of glossy accents, because I have a lot of splatter and I just love the splatter to add some glossy accents. So they will look like dewdrops, and this is something I really do love a lot. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for taking part in this hop. I wish you all good luck with winning the prizes. Stay safe, and please do subscribe if you like what I do, and hit the notification bell just under the video to be notified about my upcoming videos. Have a lovely day. Bye bye.